Zash, has your research turned up anything else on this terrorist ghost?
Ni pate uvaro is sandan sware kanidede akja swaluda is.
Figures the old lady isn't around when we need her.
Gine na gangan gisat.
I'm sorry, but I need to speak with her.
Anims jay fragibans, imbate sunjas, puijangardos wai parpana.
You're right, Kemval. We must find a way to cope without her. What did she say about Terrace?
Something about some Jedi investigating an old Sith ghost. Said she had a Sith on the planet looking into it. Elios Malus, I think. Surprised there's only one ghost. Story goes, some crazy Darth blew the whole planet to pieces while his own Sith were still on it. Not very practical, but it ain't my business. Anyway, I'd hunt out this Malus guy in the Imperial base and hope he has some answers.
Elios Malus, you were sent here to investigate a ghost. What did you discover?
I am a busy man. I don't have time for... Oh, my lord, I forgive me. I didn't recognize you in your new wardrobe. So grand. This is a pleasant surprise. I had heard the most unfortunate rumors.
You're better off not believing anything anyone says about me.
Yes, of course. The grapevine does lie, doesn't it? Now, you are asking about the ghost, yes? Let me see. I assure you I've been hard at work assessing the situation. It's just the Jedi have been guarding the old Jedi Enclave very tightly. That's where the ghost first appeared, you see.
Have there been other appearances in other places?
On the contrary, there have barely been any appearances at all. The ghost appears only sporadically. Not even the Jedi who guard the Enclave can make it appear. They've resorted to using a young Padawan to try and draw the ghost out through blood ties or something. Foolishness if you ask me, but I'm a man of meager understanding.
Why do the Jedi care if the ghost appears?
My understanding is the ghost doesn't need to appear to be felt, and the Jedi don't like the dark side lingering in their enclave. Seems if the Padawan can make the ghost appear, they can cleanse it, or whatever it is Jedi do with ghosts.
I need this Padawan too, in that case.
If you wish to make the ghost appear, then I'd say it's worth a try. If you could manipulate this Padawan, her name's Ashara Zavros, into assisting you, you could gain both the ghost and a new apprentice. I can't imagine an impressionable young Padawan being able to resist your particular charms, and it would save you the trouble of fighting a small army of Jedi.
Not a bad idea.
I live ever to please. Of course, you'll need to entice her away from her Jedi protectors. You might visit the Jedi training grounds by the waterfall. It's abandoned now, dangerous. The data recorders there may hold certain insights into her personality. In the meantime, I will endeavor to learn what I can of her Jedi masters.
I can't do it. You know what? You want to move a rock? Get a quarry droid.
Calm down, Ashara. There is no emotion. There is peace. Try it again.
I tried. I tried already. I can't do it.
Trust in the Force, and even the oldest and sturdiest of walls may be pulled down.
Forget this. If there really are Sith on Terrace, we should be fighting them, not sitting here daydreaming.
Patience, Ashara. One must empty oneself of emotion and find the peace with which to act in the Force. Now, try again.
There is no passion. There is serenity. Can anyone explain what this means? Ashara.
It means that Jedi must be prepared to think calmly, even in intense situations. Passion is a tool of the dark side. There is no emotion. There is peace. It also means Jedi should temper their intuition with wisdom. There is no ignorance. There is knowledge.
Very good, Ashara. So you see, this line of the code ties earlier elements of the code together. Relent. That's an order.
But I was winning.
You must learn restraint. Varric is clearly not your equal. There was no reason to press the attack.
We're training for war. The Sith won't surrender. We have to drive them back with everything we've got.
These are not Sith. They are fellow Padawans.
You show great potential, Ashara. But you must temper your fervor for the light with patience.
Cassius will be in the assault group. The rest of you will be support. Any questions? Then take your positions.
Master Ryan, I think you put me in the wrong group.
You are in the support group, Ashara. You will provide backup to the assault team.
That's what I mean. I should be on the assault team. Varric can barely hold a lightsaber.
Learning to support your fellow Jedi is an important skill. Varric lacks your confidence, and so requires your compassion and encouragement.
But Master Ryan!
Enough, Ashara. You have received your instructions. Join the others if you wish to complete your trial.
I found the databanks. Our Padawan has a bit of a pride problem. She is a less than perfect Jedi candidate.
Most excellent. In my experience, pride and insecurity go hand in hand. My lord, you went searching for crumbs and discovered a feast.
She feels as though the Jedi don't trust her strength. I must show her that I do.
Yes, excellent thinking. Promise her power or wealth, something to win her trust. Let me think, what could we use? It must be something tempting to a young Padawan.
Do you have any suggestions?
Well, my lord, I am hardly an expert on this sort of thing, but let me think. Ah, yes, here we are. This outpost here used to be occupied by the servants of a powerful Sith. Supposedly, they left behind a holocron when they abandoned the site in haste. Its contents are probably beneath you, but what Padawan isn't tempted by the lure of forbidden knowledge?
Tempts her into using the holocron, and let its dark side knowledge do the rest.
Precisely. Once the girl comes over to the dark side, she will do whatever you ask. Of course, you will need to find the holocron first. The abandoned outpost is in a nearby region. I'll transfer the location, but be warned, it's swarming with rat ghouls and other monstrosities.
I've found the holocron.
Excellent news, my lord. And I'm pleased to say that I found the perfect place for you to lure your Padawan to. An area of swamp near enough to Republic territory that she'll feel secure, yet remote enough that she'll be truly at your mercy.
I am most grateful.
I suggest you contact the girl using a holocommunicator from a nearby Republic soldier. In the past, Sith often used dark side holocrons to turn weak-willed Jedi. If you can convince the Padawan to look, she'll fall easily.
Thank you. Ashara Zavros, I've discovered an item that I believe might be of interest to you. A holocron of some power.
Who are you? How did you know my name? What makes you think I'm interested in a holocron?
The truth is, I'm a Sith, and I need your help.
A Sith? How did you get this frequency? Stay away, or I'll cut you in two.
I'm not overly familiar with the Jedi Code, but I don't remember the part about bisecting people.
If driving villains like you from the galaxy isn't what a Jedi does, I don't know what is. I want nothing to do with you or your dark secrets, or that holocron. Why call me? Why not take this holocron to one of the Masters? Ryan or Osera?
Aren't you a Jedi? Why should you have to defer to them?
Yes. I am a Jedi. But even if I was interested, I shouldn't leave the base.
This is your chance to show your masters that you're worthy of handling such a delicate item.
You're right. I can prove myself. I'll come. Just tell me where to meet you.
The swamps near Republic territory.
Yes, I know the place. I'll meet you there as soon as I can. If they ask, I'll tell my masters I've gone to train.
Afandiban.
Alright, Sith, I came, but no tricks. Don't think you can kill me easily because I'm a Padawan. Even Master Osera can't beat me with a lightsaber.
Such intensity. Such fire. Those are Sith qualities.
Jedi are not without emotions, but they channel them toward the greater good and the protection of others. Is that the holocron? You surprise me, Sith. I didn't think you people knew how to tell the truth. Strange. I've never held one of these before. I expected it to be heavier.
They are remarkable objects. Care to have a look inside?
I don't know. The Masters don't let Padawans handle holocrons.
There's much a Padawan can learn from a holocron.
And I'm sure I will learn all those things in time. But for now, I must take this holocron to the Masters. I'm not sure they will approve, but I feel like I ought to give you something as a thank you for the holocron.
You know how to raise the ghost in the Jedi Enclave.
The ghost? No. No Sith can enter the Jedi Enclave. What do you want with him anyway?
My master wants me dead. I need the ghost's help to defeat him.
But there's no ritual that can get this ghost to aid you. The Masters would have learned to pacify it by now if it was possible. What makes you think you can get its help?
I know an ancient technique used to pacify ghosts. It requires great sacrifice. I don't know if the ritual will succeed, but I must try.
The Masters have guarded the Enclave with good reason, I think.
Let them see when you summon the ghost. I promise no harm will come to them.
They would easily overpower you if you tried anything. We have a deal. I will go prepare the Enclave and inform the Masters. There she is, the Sith who wants the ghost.
You were right to tell us, Ashara. The Jedi Enclave is no place for Sith, and this one gives me an uneasy feeling.
Blame it on my misspent youth.
This is not a flippant matter. I won't have dark side rituals performed in this Enclave.
I'm sorry, but they gave me no choice. They attacked me.
Master Ryan! Master Osara, what have I done? What have I done?
I understand you're upset, but we have a ghost to deal with.
You're right. There is no emotion. There's peace. I guess there's nothing left to do now but summon the ghost.
Excellent. Truly remarkable. My lord, you are utterly clever and resourceful. Thank you so much for clearing out the Jedi for us.
If this is what I think it is, know that I don't take kindly to betrayal.
I'm sorry it had to end this way, but you were dead, and Darth Thanaton made a better offer. He's made me a lord. Unfortunately, he's also asked that you be executed. My regrets.
What's this bloodshed in my grave? I warned you not to summon me again. I warned you to leave me in peace. To keep your Jedi away from my grave.
Please, I'm sorry. This Sith needed to speak with you.
Your apology is worthless. You must die.
I won't let that happen.
What are you? Strange. How long has it been since I felt at peace? Centuries, at least. What do you want that you went through all this effort to speak to me?
If you will let me bind you, I promise to free you when my enemies are defeated.
Will it get me out of this accursed enclave with its artifacts of the light? Then I accept. Seal the pact with blood, Sith, and my power is yours.
The pact is sealed.
My strength is yours, Sith. Use it well.
What did you just do?
I took the power that was rightfully mine.
What happens now?
Help me use my power to serve the light.
I don't know. I guess I can't return to the Jedi after this, can I? Fine, I'll come. But I won't go against the Jedi teachings.
Wardahai Wistai Rojans.
Take it easy.
Looks as if we have two new travelers. The ghost and a little Jedi pet. Wonderful. The pirate thinks he has another ghost story for us to investigate, too.
My lord, it's Carl, your apprentice. Corin's here with me. We don't have much time to talk. Thanaton tried to make us his. Claimed you were dead. We managed to flee Drummond Kaas, but his lords have been hounding us through every sector.
Where are you now?
We've set a course for Quesh, a nasty little swamp world. The warfare on the planet should allow us to hide from Thanaton. We need your help. We took something from Thanaton, something to help you beat him.
Blast! Ship's hit! Emergency landing on Quesh! Hurry!
If Thanaton kills your apprentices, he will appear very weak indeed. It looks like hunting ghosts will have to wait.